life is a driving force, etc. Our emotion is equally important. It's like an intelligence. And it's equally important as our IQ. That's why he gives the term, it's a bit of opposite emotional and intelligence.
Yes.
Yes, but that's why he's using it. He says, it's so important that this part, which is the emotion, the heart, it's intelligent.
Okay.
And sometimes, later on, now that he works with Dalai Lama, etc., he turns it along to spirituality, he says, actually, in some matters and in some decisions, it's much more powerful than the IQ, the emotional part, because it is stronger and conquers this as well. And the person that is balanced and developed is able to have a balanced both and have a third element, which is the spirit. He's into spiritual events, which has nothing to do with religion. The spirit is the force above mind, heart. It is topnevma, which is something, it's a Greek term, which is something pneumatiki. That's why he's using this antithetical term, which is emotional intelligence, that are contrast, but is intelligence, you know, to give validity.
But I guess it depends also on the level of your IQ, because if your IQ is around 75 or 80%, you have a more difficult life than me, for example, or the Stavros has 130.
Okay, I'll tell you something. This is questionable, it's a very good comment being made, but I will tell you, according to this theory and to Daniel Goldman, I believe it, for the sake of humanity, Stavros, sorry, that you're using as an example, with 130, 135, statistics have shown that he, if he's not found in the right environment, with the right stimulus, with the right circumstances, because exactly he's extremely intelligent, or he might, because he's able to see, he might be more miserable than the person at 70. So what makes us happy and content and satisfied is very relative.